Hey everybody, this is Ann Clemmer. It is Wednesday. It is the Wild Wednesday, the one where I stamped the night before. And so I'm here with toothpicks, but I'm here with you and I'm glad you're here. I'm here with Stamper from StamperDog.com. Let's get started.
Stamper, come.
Oh boy, yes, we had a great time last night. We had a wonderful time last night. Oh, and I am so glad you were here waiting for me. Oh, our Facebook, you guys are always on time. I try to get started early, and Laura's over there. Yeah, we're going to be showing Laura's card. Hold on. Let me get slicked up. Yeah. Oh, there was going to be one thing that was left off the plan today. I just knew it because, you know, it's hard after I've gone and you know, stamped with people the night before. And, you know, almost all of us had both our shots. You know, I sound like a dog. Yeah. Yeah. And so I was planning on this being the thing left out, that I wouldn't do my hair. Hey, I should wear that. Yeah, it looks pretty good. So if my hair starts, no, I'm putting it back on. Yeah, okay, I'm good now. Don't take this personally. Yeah, it is crazy today. So, got a couple cards here. Yeah, and one of them's over there. No, it isn't. No, it isn't. No, it isn't. We're going to get started right away with some happy mail. You know, that kind of mail that makes you feel good. And this is what Laura sent my husband. Isn't that nice? And it's funny because he did his first cut of the season. Yeah. And he brought it to me, you know, and he was like, going, I don't know who this is. I'm like, that's okay, I do. But look at this. I love what you put here, up here. Hope you have a great year. Thanks for making my girl happy. And Stamper too. Because, you know, he does do a lot. However, Stamper was very social last night. Yeah, he was very social. He just wanted to be around the girls. And I mean, so much so that whenever we went and opened up the door to the bedroom, he just came bounding out like, oh, my fans. So, oh, Nita, how is it up where you are? She's in a higher elevation than I am, but she's like 40 minutes up the road, 30 minutes, depending on how you drive. And it's like this, it's like a package of sheets and it's that long. Yeah, sorry about that. Well, we're looking for the adhesive sheet pack, and I brought almost everything out, you know. Oh, Cecil, I have it. That's the second thing I've asked him for today. See, it is not easy doing the job of being Ann's husband at this point. No, this is too hot. I'm sorry. You're just going to have to put up with a bad hair day. Well, it's not a bad hair day. I've got hair on my head, and I'm thankful for it. Got it? Good. See, look at, and this is what happened yesterday. We were, you know, we were inside, and all of a sudden you see the whirly giggle. You know, it was really going. Yeah, it was really going. And then all of a sudden it was windy, but not bad. So, hey, yeah, we got Pueblo, Colorado. Hey, give us a shout out where you're from, because I don't know where everybody's from. You know, and like Beverly's down there in Florida. You know, some things I remember, like, you know, with some of my team members, I have to remember how to spell Pennsylvania. Yeah. So then one of my friends who's in Stamp Club, look at, she made me this. She's a cat lady. Yeah, she's a cat lady. That's what I texted her back. I said, thank you, cat lady. So anyway, we did a card last night. Oh, you know what I did not do? You know what I did not do? I did not go and look up the names and make the wheel for those of you who found the original card from Monday's video. So, hey, I guess I'm going to do that on Friday, and we're going to do that again today. Well, no, I shouldn't. No, can't do it with this one, because in today's blog post, I put a link to the original card, and we made this card like 3.5 years ago, but some things we're going to do different because that's just who we are. And then I'm going to show you, you know, after we're done today, you know, go over to the dog's blog, go and click on, I think, did I put the link below? I think I did, at least over on YouTube, but go over there and then watch the video. It's only like 3.5 minutes, right? Oh my goodness. Yeah. I went, oh, I really, my thought process was really weird. And like last night I showed him, this is the way I did it, but you kinetically figure it out whichever way you want. Cause I've been stamping with all of them, you know, for a long time, except for Eileen. Eileen's going to be new, and you know, she's got fit right in. So I guess it would help if I showed you today's card. I just don't get tired of these guys. See, this to me, it's darker than that. Should I see, it looks more like that color to me in real life. So I probably have these lights too bright, but you know, hey. But what I would do to do this, look at, and we didn't even do anything. Yeah, I'm sorry, Marcy. You know, if we're all careful, no matter what the rule is, if we're all careful, yeah, we're gonna all be better off. So when you're doing this card, I do recommend this butterfly. And see, this is how this comes. This is all one. And you see, this goes over this, right? And you know what I just found out? Oh my goodness. Yes, Anne, I just need to, the color, the paper is Blushing Bride. But with this, this butterfly bijou paper is only going to be available while supplies last. It will not be in the new catalog. So if you like this, and believe me, it is awesome, even if you don't like butterflies, because look at that. It's got patterns as well as butterflies. I've seen good stuff made with, well, see here, here's one of the cards that I got in a swap. Yeah. And like this one, the butterfly was cut out. She didn't go and color that. No, she went and took it out of that. Yeah. So anyway, it comes with all this. So you can cut out a bunch of butterflies, or you can, you see what I did with those magnets? Yeah. See what I did with those magnets? And see, I'm keeping it because there's too many to put in the case. The dies and the stamps, and this is just one stamp, which I have on my Stamparatus right now. But this is the one I would use because it's big enough to be impressive, but it's not as big as this. This one, well, you could put this one in, but see, you've got these bad boys, and they could cause some issues. And the rest of them are a little bit smaller. So I would take the second largest butterfly to do this. Now, one thing that we did differently, that I had them do differently, I had them go and texture this before we put it together. Yes, that wood paper is different. Yeah, it's very slick. I don't know that I would stamp on it. I haven't played with it a lot. You know, there's so many stamps in so little time. So yeah, so let's make this, because, and then afterwards go back and you'll see, wow, Anne, okay, I did the same thing, only different. So one thing I did not do is do the butterfly in advance, but that better for you, because now you're going to see the whole thing. This is 3.5 by 4.75. You know, and I keep saying I'm going to bring some paper up here, you know, and do I, yeah, it's all pretty much branded, you know, and it's like, yeah. So here we can put it on this there. Right there. Look at it. It's been 3.5, 4.75. Blushing bride. How about that? I was lucky. This is the first time I actually went and put the name of the, put a picture of the project up before we started. I went, oh golly. And then I was going, what if I want to change my mind? Cause you know, it's my prerogative, right? Bobby Brown. You know what? Nita's got a good idea. Nita's got a good idea. And so is Deb. She said, just buy another set because I know someone who she bought two sets because they're only $17. And if $17 is a great investment, which I think it is, you can go and have both sets, have one where they're all together and then have one where they're all cut up, or else just bite the bullet, decide you're going to cut it up. The only thing is that one is going to make it a little bit harder to, if you want to do them all at the same time. Yeah, that's right. There you go. There you go, Deb. I have smart team members. Yeah. So here, let me go. And while I go over and I'm going to texturize this, and then I'm going to go and I'm going to texturize this, and then I'm going to go and cut that butterfly out. Hopefully I have everything right. But hey, if you have not signed up for our Zoom party that we're going to be doing to celebrate March. I mean, come on, March. It's a great month. You've got my husband's birthday, which is Friday. And then you've got St. Patrick's Day. And then, hey, it's March. And we're going to be doing a Zoom party it's a mystery party. Yeah, it's a mystery card party. But those of you who have gone know that that's not the best part of it. The best part of it is that we get together and we have a pet parade. If you don't have a pet, that's okay. You can hold up a picture of your pet. You can hold up a goldfish. That would be fun. Yeah. And then we're going to have games afterwards. Yeah, so that's, we're doing it with Zoom because the people who play, that's what they decided they want to do. And we may in the future go and, do one at Zoom and one on Facebook, one on Zoom, one on Facebook, now that I've learned things. Yeah, you know how it is. I'm not doing anything that you don't know how to do over here. So yeah, go and on YouTube, I know there's a link below, but I know there's one over on yesterday's post for the dog. Okay, I'm not doing anything without you here yet. Yet. So if you're feeling lucky, yeah, because everybody gets a prize. Everybody gets a prize. I don't, that's just a quirky thing about me. I think I like to do things where, like for competition, I compete with myself. I don't compete with other demonstrators. I'm just not a big competition person. I guess maybe that's because my parents didn't have me play sports as a kid other than PE, whatever they did in PE. Yeah, that's as good as it got. But I do remember being on the winning homeroom basketball team, girls basketball team in junior high. That was fun. But anyway, okay, so this is what we did. We went and I put the texture on here first, and then I went and cut this out. Now you'll notice I have a fairly new, yes, can you tell what we used? Fairly new set of cutting plates, because when you're cutting out fine stuff like this, it really helps to have the cutting plates. This, if I pushed it, they'll come out. I don't really care. Maybe I'll use it on another project. But all those little sticky bits stick to the plate. And there are some tips in the video that I forgot all about. But on the video, we went in and put, glue to put this on. We're not going to put glue on this. We're going to do something else. Okay, so flip, slide. Okay, I just want to make sure I have this right when I go back over there. Now it's for this bad boy. Now this is the one where it gets interesting. By the way, I cut this out. I think it's 3 by 3.5. And that's so that you have some wiggle room. You know, like this one's going to fit fine, like right about here. And I'm only going to cut off just a little bit. When you put this in here, I would not recommend putting it that close to the edge, maybe down a little bit. See, this one is down a little bit, but this, I've got it close on both sides. And it gives you some idea, you know, so you want something that has contrasting bits in it. Since we're putting dark on there, we will want a lot of light and color. So now, this is what you've been waiting for. This is the old kind, I can tell. I can tell, this is the old one. Write this down, because if you find it, if you like it, if you write it down, then you won't care. But if you, 1, 5, 2, 3, 3, 4. And they're klebogen. Yeah, I don't know if that's the way you say it. They're adhesive sheets. And they are 12 by 6, so you can get a lot out of it. But what's nice about these is, I'm sure I have a partial sheet over there. There's a break in it. See, look at, there's a break here. And see, I only need like that much. I only need that much. So we're going to take our junky scissors. I shouldn't call them that. They might get jealous. I'm going to cut it like here. And you don't actually, you want to know the truth? You don't have to have it on the whole thing. You really don't. Somebody put theirs together. They didn't have it on top. You could top it up. See, that's close enough. And now I'm going to take this on the side that's broken. See, this side's not broken, but this side is. And it just makes it easier to go and pull that off. Now you can do it like this, or you can take it off all at the same time. I kind of like to take it off this way. Then I don't have too much danger zone exposed. Keep wanting to move this. But you know what that is. Now when you put this on, you just want to put it through on the other side. And by watching my video today that I watched after the fact, it helps to put you could put a shim underneath it if you have a hard time cutting this out, because nothing's gonna get all those bits out. Let's just, you know, this right here. Okay, here. See if I bend it a little bit, but you don't want to break the fibers too much. But look at, I'm pushing out from underneath, and they're coming up. So they do take a little bit, but you don't want to like this, because you're going to like have a butterfly that'll look like you put him in the washing machine. Yeah, and that's not gonna work. He's not gonna be too happy about that. You could use the top of the take your pick tool, right, to go and rub over it, right? And then, oh, what else? Yeah, and you don't even have to take them all out. Like, I just sent them home with a pink butterfly. Oops. Have to get that in the right spot so that the camera knows what to... Oh, boy. Yeah, I think I'm going to bring a vacuum cleaner in here. So, anyway, remember, when I'm putting this on, I'm putting it on here, right? And I'm going to try a shim because it's right next to my scrap thing. Yeah. It's right next to my scrap thing. So yeah, that's where I'm going to put it. So now, if you've been on one of our earlier calls, you're going to know that You don't have to put a shopping code in. It'll if you go to shop to the, with a dog.com, it'll automatically put one on there for you. If you spend over $150, guess what? You can take it out if you want to. My feelings won't be hurt. I want you to, you know, but don't worry. I will always do what is in your best interest. Don't tell anybody. They'll get jealous. Everybody will want that. Yeah. So I put a shim underneath it. Oh, it makes it a little bit harder to crank. We used two, they're still using my old Big Shot. But I did bring this out last night. I did bring this out last night just to, because we, you know, Eileen was here for the first time. Well, the second time. You're not looking. There you go. Okay. So here it is in its all its glory. There. Yep. He just came out and that's fine. I don't mind that those are like that. Where you may have an issue is right here. I put, when I say a shim, I happen to have another piece of cardstock that was exactly the same size. So it, I just laid it underneath the bottom cutting pad. So that then I'd have the base and whatever parts of the base, what is it? 1 and 2, right? And then I had, the shim, the other piece of cardstock, then I had number 3, and then I had this and this, and then I had the other number 3. But it's funny because Cindy had mentioned, she goes, oh, it didn't cut all the way through, and you do not want to. Yeah, you know what? I keep those around. I keep those around, but they dry out by the time I come and use them, so yeah. And actually, there is a way to take care of this, you know, typing paper, computer paper, copy paper, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, that's a good way to do this here. Yeah. Let's see how this goes. What you want to do, you don't want to, if these don't come out, that's great. That's great because I don't want them to come out. I want to, here, I'm going to hold that close. Not bad, not bad. Yeah. Not bad. That's interesting. Great. Hold on 1 second. I have 2 here with I always have a plan B, but where's the plan B? Oh boy, there it is. I didn't pick up my take your pick tool, but all I'm going to do is go through here. And a good thing to do is to like I said, you can go and twist it a little bit. But these, they're coming out, you know. This is the part where, and most of them did. I mean, let's applaud the ones that exited the room graciously. How's the top of my head looking? Oh, no. I don't know. This is the best butterfly set ever. Now look at, see, this, something stuck over here. One of these. Oh, look who decided to come to work. Oh, Stamper, you're shaking a little bit. Are you cold or are you just excited? Yeah, he does shake every now and then. He's done that for a while now. It used to be when he would get really excited. And, you know, if you don't take him for enough walks, that's what happens. All that excitement, all that adrenaline, you know, just stores up in his body and he has to release it. But somebody noticed it at a Christmas party. And that's when I started watching it more. they were saying, oh, you said that the other card was going to be the hardest. And they were like, this was hard. And I'm like, this isn't hard. This is just menial labor, you know. There we go. So you just want to keep that as flat as possible. Okay, now this is where I got weird. This is where I got weird. So what I did, this is the way I did it. I went like this and I said, okay, find which way you want this on here. Maybe you want it that way. And this is not the way I did it in the original. Oh, sorry. Stamper, you're a camera hound. Yes, it all cut out. And so if you're having problems or, okay, let's not call them problems. I think we kind of do our whole mindset based on that. But if we call them challenges, then I think we feel like we have more control. Because, you know, you are what you speak about most. And I keep saying I'm skinny and that's going to catch up every now and then. Eventually. Yeah. I've got a piece here. There it is. There. But, you know, is that like, oh, see, here's one. And if you put it on there and you realize that there's some that you left in there, big deal. So anyway, what I did, I put this where I wanted it. Then I went and as long as you don't press it down, you're going to be fine. And then I pressed it on here. Okay. Does anybody know what's going to happen? If you pick this up, it'll come right off of there. Yeah. Yeah. You got to be careful with that. Those antennae. That's why I don't like that big one because this one, see, look it. And that's okay. That's okay because I'm going to, you know, I gave somebody my scissors last night and they got put in the bucket with everybody else's. So that's a good thing I have too. But you want to take these bits off that are not important. These don't matter. You don't have to. This is going to be trapped in there anyway. And I'm going to put a dot of glue on there just to, and I mean, you notice, I mean a dot of glue, just dot of glue every now and then. And especially like right there. And if you have, oh, sorry, Stamper. One of these Teflon mats that we have, if bonus points, if somebody has this, has their catalog, it's with the adhesive stuff. And there, I'm going to put that on there. This is not the way I did it when I did it six years ago, but close. Okay. But close. And then I'm going to take, now today, honestly, I don't watch other demonstrators a lot. I just don't because I want it to be you and me, right? You and me, we're just here in my stamp room. We're hanging out. The dog's licking my leg. Yeah, he couldn't resist. Anyway, and it's just you and me, and we're designing this card together. Well, this one was pre-designed, but at least I'm telling you everything that happened last night while I remember it. But today, when I was getting ready, I went, oh, you know, here's a something, you know, and somebody went and took a piece like this that had been, see, I can hold it up now. And yes, there's a little itty bitty piece of right there. Without my bifocals, I know I'm picking up something else there. See, here's the trick. Anyway, I just wanted to be us, but I was going to tell you before I lose that thought. This was with a really high up and down embossing folder used on it. And then they went and used this, and I'm going, that debosses what you've embossed. So whenever you go and use an embossing folder, it's really a good idea to use this. So yeah, so there, I'm telling you that, and I'm sticking to it. Now, what was the other thing I was gonna say? I don't know. Yes, about the camera angle. Sometimes I'll show you stuff and you'll think that it, like if I hold it like this, you'll think it's peaking. Well, that's because the camera is not coming straight down. It's like at a slight angle like this. So sometimes you'll see something and like that. That's not, well, okay, maybe that is. Let's see, look at with the paper snips. And if you don't have a pair of these, you definitely should get them because they are nice and sharp. Don't poke yourself with this end. That's why they come with a cover. And it's a great idea to keep that on because you can bend those tips. But anyway, yeah. Isn't that beautiful? Just like that. But anyway, I put this on here because this will keep your, you know, underneath this, I have a grid pad. I always have a grid pad. Always, always, always. And, yeah. Grid pad, and then, but that'll keep your grid pad clean. Okay, we're going to write this next number down. Otherwise, I get rid of that post-it note that is in, it's the bane of my existence. Stamper, he was laying right behind me. If I would have tried to take a step back without kind of feeling it, I would have probably fallen over. Yeah. So here we go. There's that. And it's a good thing I have it here because we're putting, you know, we're laying this down. It's got navy and black and you know, try to see. And also then with that, you get some hang time. Now you'll notice that this is a really thin border. And that's because I just want it to be kind of like those borders. And so let me see if I can remember this. This is 3 11/16, and this is 4 15/16, and that's night and navy. Now I'm going to tell you, if you think I'm really smart, well, yes, I am. Okay. Yeah. All this is three little lines above 3.5, right? It's one little line, depending on if you have something that shows 16ths, right? One little line smaller than 3 3/4. And this is one little line under 5. So don't be freaking out about those 16ths. Yeah. Once I remember them that way, it's a lot easier to remember. And then hats off to those of you who always score, but I always have my hands on me and I don't always have the trimmer. Well, I actually do have the trimmer next to me, but I got started in the days before. Yeah. Yet these paper snips. Yeah, it's a nice birthday treat. Yeah, I think I'll buy Cecil a pair. And then, you know, after like you use them like 5 6 years and you're like going, these aren't as sharp because people have been cutting through glue and stuff. Because, you know, for things that are sticky, I still have my school scissors and look at, they got my name on them, you know. And these are good for things that you know, like if it's sticky or maybe it's a piece of cardboard or something, then I use these because I want to keep these as nice as I can for as long as I can. I've had this pair for like a long time because Stampin' Up! Doesn't make those charms anymore. I always give me the newest pair that I share with you. So yeah. Okay. I have to ask, who here watches PBS? And if you do, did you watch Les Miserables 25 year? 25-year anniversary, which was actually almost 11 years ago. That thing was would still be playing in London if we let it. Yeah, because this song is sticking in my head. Okay, rookie thing now. Always double check which way your card's going before you put this on. And yes, I still used glue underneath this because it gives you hang time, which I didn't need, but it also goes and it doesn't deboss this because you want to make sure that's nice. Yeah, it's if you know the story of Les Miserables, in fact, I like the Liam Neeson version from 1998. I kind of Googled it after that. It was done again later, but anyway, so there's that. Now let's get back to the other. Hold on. I grabbed a few of these. What we did was everybody went and did a whole sheet of the mini messages. I'm not going to do it. I'm just going to show you a trick with this. Don't do that, Em. But what I did was, see, look at my name on here. My label is not straight, but that's okay. It's straight over here. And this was not here. That was just for storage. When you're doing this, I just took a half sheet of cardstock and I did the thick and I put it up here so that it was that far down. I put it up against that. Whoops, sorry, there. Sorry about my pointing finger, but I'm holding on to stuff. I put it up against that and then I made sure that we lined it up with, I think like this line over here. Yeah, so that they could go back and press again if they didn't get a good press. You do have to be careful because if you move it too much, these lines are fine and they will, and they'll get a little bit drunk. I don't know. That one turned, I threw away the ones I didn't think made the cut. I also did mine both sides, but if you do them at a thick whisper white and thick, basic white, and thick very vanilla, I think that then you can keep these really well and you want to go outside, Cecil? He can't hear you. He's looking at me and like, help. Either that or hold on one. Maybe he wants to get on the picture. Okay, are you okay? Stamper. He can't hear, so you know it's well, very well. Come on, there you go. Go. It's important to teach your dog hand signals before they lose their hearing. He can hear like higher pitched things, but you know, he's been a good and faithful dog to us for 15 years now. And okay, let's not talk about that. Anyway, so we just try to make it the best for him we can. Anyway, so yeah, you just want to be careful not to move it a lot. I think everybody took these and they put them in a, they put them in, I gave them little baggies. So see now, look at, I've got this and you could make a bunch of these just like this, right? And then look at, I can put this on there. I can put this on there, right? And you don't have to put them in the same place like that, sending a smile. Just a card to say hello. We might need a bigger thing, you know, bigger thing. You know, I'm looking more as the shape, you know, the size. See, look at it. And when you use that thick, look at, you can go. Okay, so I'm going with this, but I'm going to change it up just a little bit. Okay. He's already back. How was that, Stamper? It's funny. He kind of depends. He depends on me to translate. Okay. He does not see. Look, I went on the other side and I just didn't like the way. See, this is what was it. That was a little bit thick. I don't know. Maybe I'm just being too picky. The only thing with this is that if you're going to go and stamp something on the inside, it takes a little bit of extra thought process. But you know, I'm more about writing something on the inside. I have to have a couple things here, cards for tonight. I got one done. Oh, top of my head is looking great. Hey, so, you know, if you watched our Monday show, I did say to go and find the original card. And put a comment on there, and then I'm going to do a drawing about, you know, for who did it. Okay, so see, I think that's too high for me to go and put this here. I think I'm still going to put it like there. And then rather than putting these here, I'm just going to put them. Oh, wow. I could put them right there. Different places around here. Yeah. Or else you could just put two of them up in the top. There is some kind of placement issues. Either way, it's a great little card. And like I said, you could go and do a bunch of the mini messages. Yeah, the dies are on back order, but they're coming. I think it's next week because one of the people who ordered it. Yeah, it was our goodbye to Barbara last night. That was kind of hard. But yeah, see, look at no matter which one you use, they're both. Either way. And this original card, I think. Oh, hey, let me show you something real quick and so that you can see this. Hold on. So that, you know, because everything isn't, you know, I don't have to like find something brand new, but it's just funny. Hold on one second. So I can bring this around. Okay, hold on. Okay, when you go to the dog's blog, right? Here's the card. And there's a link. Yes. And sign up for our mailing list. That should pop up. Yep. Anyway, if you're looking for something, you see up here, I'm going to show you how I found this. Of course, actually I'd found it in Pinterest. It just popped up and I went, oh, I remember doing this. And then it made, but if I were thinking about it, look at it, it's inlaid butterfly. Okay. And let me see if I can find it that way. I don't know if that way, I know if I just type butterfly in there, it comes up. Let's see. Maybe I'm asking there. Okay. That's this type. And there's the other one. And see, that'll look at, if there's something that, you know, I did and you want to find it, then there it is. And there is the original card. And it takes you back to June 17th, 2015. And there it is. It's just a little bit different. You know, it's just a little bit different. It's still done with vanilla, but, and it's still done with designer series paper in the back. And, but look at, it's just a totally different experience because this one is all in color. And that one has a massive amount of very vanilla. Hey, I am so glad that you came and hung out with me today. You know, if you got something out of it, or maybe you thought, well, maybe I'll get something out of her next time, make sure you like and subscribe. Yeah, we love it when you come back, and we tend to be a big, happy family, and you could be part of that. This is Ann Clemmer and Stamper from StamperDog.com, where we try to put a little ink, paper, and fun yes. into your day. Hey, Friday, 4:00. It's going to be our sale. You want to be here. See you then.